How you doing today? This is Jeff from ATS, and today I'm going to be starting a series of training videos on the ATS eScope Elite Oscilloscope. And today's training is how to use the Mach 360 feature, which is located on the Measure and Deep Record tab. And we added this feature to quickly and accurately measure crankshaft to camshaft position correlation in degrees. I'm going to begin by loading a suspected bad waveform from a 2011 Lexus GS430. And just to make note, channel 1 yellow is the crankshaft position sensor. Channel 2 red is the intake cam sensor. Channel 3 green is the exhaust cam sensor. And I do have channel 4 blue, which is an ignition reference from the number 1 coil. So in order to use this feature, we only need 360 degrees. And what we see on our waveform is I have a full 720 degrees zoomed in on this capture. So I'm going to click start by click get cursors. I'm going to move cursor to what I'm going to refer to as a zero reference point. And I'm moving the second one to 360 degrees. And we're going to mark 360. You'll note in the upper right the degrees are indicating 360 degrees. And to clarify, I'm using this as a zero reference, this as 360. If I chose, I could move the cursors over to here, mark the 360, and then this is 360 degrees. My preference is just to use this one. This one, and we're going to remark it as 360. So the first thing I'm going to do is move the cursor from 360 degrees to the intake cam position sensor, and I'm going to get it in the middle here. And we'll note in the upper right that that is 82.2 degrees from my zero reference point. Now I'm going to use a hidden feature in the eScope Elite to create an annotation, and I will cover that in a training another day. It's very simplistic. I'm going to put my cursor where I want my anchor to be. I'm going to right click and I'm going to create an annotation. This is going to be intake 82.2 degrees. We'll click OK, and we can choose the color or the channel. You'll note they follow our channel references. I'm going to use white just for clarity, and I'll move it a little bit to the left. So our intake is again 82.2 degrees from our zero reference point. Now I'm going to move that cursor to my exhaust cam position sensor, noting it's 179 degrees, and I'm going to create a second annotation. Right clicking, create annotation, and I'm going to say exhaust 179.0. I'm going to choose white again, and we'll move this off to the side. And just to label what this capture is, I'm going to move my cursors out of the way. I'm going to do another right click, create an annotation. This time I'm going to hide the arrow, and I'm going to go 2001 Lexus GS430 suspected bad. And we'll go white and we'll move that down a little bit. So at this point, I like to capture the screen, and I'm going to do that by going File, Save Screen, and we're going to label it 2001 Lexus GS430 suspected bad. I do that for a couple of reasons, mainly as we all know how hard it is to collect any diagnostic money, and if we can show the customer before and after screen captures, they don't necessarily have to understand the technical part of it, but if they see a difference, they know something is wrong. So at this point, I'm going to load my known good. Load. And I'm going to choose my known good. Now, I like to find a known good from more than one source, if at all possible. And this one I did obtain with a data file. So same as the suspected bad. And we're going to zoom window around our 360 degree. We'll get our cursors. Put one at the zero reference, one at the 360 degree mark, and we're going to mark 360. From this point, we're going to do the same thing as the suspected bad. Is we're moving to the intake and we're making note it's 82.1 degrees from our zero reference. I'm going to create my annotation. Intake at 82.1. And we're going to move it to the exhaust. And the exhaust is 167.4. I'm going to create that annotation. I'm going to choose the white again, and I am going to move it off. Move the cursors up, creating the annotation here without an arrow. 2001 Lexus GS430 known good. And we're going to do a screen capture of this. But if you've made notes or a mental note, you notice our exhaust is quite different on the known good than the suspect vehicle. But we're going to save the screen, and we're going to label this known good. And we're saving that. So again, one point I want to go over, you know, it's important, is I'm calling this my zero reference point. And if we were to start over, get my cursors, again, I can use this point, this point, this point as my zero reference as long as it's the same on both the suspect vehicle and the known good. So at this point, we're going to look at the save screens. Okay, I am going to open up and compare our known good to our suspected bad on our saved JPEGs. So you can open this in your favorite editor, viewer. I use Hypersnap, So I'm just going to right click and I'm going to open it with Hypersnap. So this is our known good. I'm going to change this to 150%. And we can see that our intake is at 82.1 and our exhaust is at 167.4 on the known good. So now I'm going to go open the suspected bad, also in Hypersnap. And I'm just going to edit, copy, and I'm going to paste it in to my original and bring it down and compare the two. And let's find a percentage where we can view it. And I'll just bring it up a little bit and align them. So again, our known good, our intake is at 82.1, our suspected bad is at 82.1. For all intents and purposes, they are identical. Known good, exhaust 167.4, and the suspect vehicle is at 179.0. So we see the difference here, and the difference is 11.6 degrees, and the suspected bad is, again, 11.6 degrees retarded from the known good. And let's bring this up a little bit better, and we can see the difference between the two here. I'm going to try to zoom in. And here we go. So again, this is a short video, the first of many on using different features of the ATS eScope Elite, and this one was on the Mach 360. And we have some other notes to make because everything isn't quite as clear or as easy as this. So give me a moment and I'm going to load up some slides and we'll review those. And while I just demonstrated on how to check cam to crank correlations, my examples show basically a simple cam position sensor off in relation to the crank. But what if the cam sensors were in proper alignment and the crank was off? So what I have here is a 2018 Ford Expedition Max 3.5 twin turbo EcoBoost that came into a shop with a crank no start. And we do have a capture of a known good, and this took 5 channels, 4 for the cam sensors, 1 for the crank. And this again is the known good. And we're going to bring up the vehicle that was a crank no start. And just visually, you can't see anything wrong. Let's compare the two. The one thing we'll note is the intake for bank one aligns on top of the bank one exhaust. Same thing in the known good. Bank two intake aligns with bank two exhaust. And again, the same thing here. So these 4 cams align to each other. So if we look at the actual vehicle and looking at an intake as a reference, because we know they all match, here's the actual vehicle, and to the right is the known good. And if we look down the bottom, the crank is off by 49.2 degrees. So we all know how complex some of these vehicles get, and this is just the timing chain illustration for that 3.5 twin turbo. So the amount of work, as we all know, to tear it down is we have to be correct in our diagnosis. We don't want to do this a second time. And in this case, the crank gear was actually cracked, broken, and shifted on the alignment pin. Now, the second example here is a 2005 Volvo XC90 that came in with a camshaft position sensor, a circuit range performance, bank one, or a single sensor. So the shop had already replaced the cam position sensor, which didn't resolve the issue. Then they replaced the computer, and again, the problem remained. And logic would tell you to look at the cam crank correlation. We did capture the crank with both the intake and exhaust cams, and let's take a look. So here is the capture. Yellow is the crank, red is the intake cam, green is exhaust, and blue is coil one ignition reference. So what do we know from this? We know we have output from the crank, the two cams, and the ignition. So we needed to obtain a known good capture for comparison. And here is our known good. And again, I'll always say it, if you know the source of the known good is reliable, then use it. But I always make it a practice to try to locate and compare more than one for comparison. So here's the actual capture and the known good. Note the difference in the white circle. This is completely missing over here. And my next slides will explain the difference. So this is how the pattern is produced on this vehicle. You'll notice a narrow wide followed by a space and then another narrow before the pattern is repeated. We have a narrow, a wide, and another narrow, and then it will repeat itself. So this narrow is right here. Here is the wide, a space, and a narrow. So I go through a little explanation on how it's constructed on this vehicle. And let's look a little further into this. So notice a broken tooth on this illustration that resulted in the pattern below. Notice how the wide followed by a space and then another narrow is repeated. And again, where there should be a narrow right here. And here is the actual cam, and I believe they're calling it an aperture on this vehicle. That tooth is missing, resulting in the pattern we see. So everything is not simple and clear. We just have to look at the data, and the data will drive us to the correct diagnosis. Again, this is Jeff from ATS. If you have any training or features you'd like me to go over, please email me at jeff@atsnm.com or post on our Facebook user group, ATS User Group. My contact is Jeff@ATS. Thank you.